it's Sam and Sam. Everyone, welcome back to some more Love, Sam. This is the final part, and all of the pieces come together, and wow, this game was crazy. Anyway, I hope you enjoy it.
How long have I been recording for? Dang! Jeez, it feels like my whole night has just been this. I mean, it's a great game, don't get me wrong, but holy crap, I wasn't expecting this long. A long time ago, when I finally got to accept my feelings, I thought everything was going to change, but every day was still like every day. He was still a school star. I was still his friend. When you live in Rosa Peak, people expect things to stay the same. Anything changed, use it. Anything changed, but it could ruin B and everything around him. But that's how it went. Nothing changed when my whole world burned. What are you talking about? Oh, I gotta put the picture there. I kept telling myself maybe after graduation I'll be able to express my feelings for him. I left the fire in my heart eat through my soul and body. I call myself a coward, but I chose to keep what little I had to enjoy. I was a poor kid, crawled up in bed. Make sure everything is recording, because I've had to like stop the recording like 7 times now, just because the file was just going on for like 10 years. Her. Poor? Do I really deserve that charity title? Am I really a victim of all this? Who's here to judge me anyway? It's all over and everyone left me. So why do I feel like I'm being chased? Like someone's always watching me. Like someone's always trying to judge me. Stacy? How did the invite go? She in or not? Who? Oh, she's coming. Dorks like her can't say no to parties. So Sarah, Sam and these are two different people. They have to be. Time to give her the drama. Yes, they are. Did we steal? Are we playing as someone who stole? Like this, why is there eyes in the window? Like we stole this person's diary. Right? Or something. I don't. Or maybe we're playing as the guy. Maybe we're the guy, like B, and we came to her room after she disappeared or, you know, threw herself off the cliff or whatever. And maybe this is us coming to this room, reading everything that she went through and now feeling bad and everything's haunting us. That is what I kind of feel like is happening right now. I know I used half of this diary writing about Stacy being a B, but now she's just unstable. He wasn't even the first class when I saw her arguing like crazy with Kyle Hurt or something like, I'm done with doing crap for you before storming away. Then she saw me and I was next target. She tried towards me and said, this is all your fault. Why don't you go back to San Diego? Whoa, what did I do? She was off before I could even open my mouth. I turned to Kyle Rance, he was gone too. Kind of think of it, I really saw them hanging out recently, but I didn't know things were this intense. Brian's been acting weird too. He hasn't talked to me much recently. He even looks somewhat more upset than usual. I finally tried to ask him what was wrong, but he cut me off short, asking if I called him last night. All I could give was a blank face until Brian said never mind and walked away. What was that about? What did he mean by again calling him in the middle of the night for no reason? Something I've dreamed of, but doesn't mean I actually did it. What the heck is going on? Yeah, you tell me. November 2nd. We're almost playing through this whole entire year. It's because of her. The moment she came in our lives, what little I had to enjoy started to crumble. Only bad things happen no matter how hard I try to protect it. A city girl just asking to become an outsider. That was all she was to me. Hell, that was all she was to everyone else, even to B. But then I saw them talking in the library. Yeah, this, I don't, I hope it explains everything. You know what I mean? I couldn't see clearly, but I could know it from B's face. He was making her smile. It was another smile taunting my feelings for B. No one would ever know what kind of emotions I was hit with at that moment. Crazy emotions. A change was happening and I didn't like it at all. Stacy didn't like it either. She could never stand letting easy social prey slip away from her. Naturally, Stacy took a peek into her diary one day. She took pictures of some of the entries and sent them to me and her gang. She wanted everyone to join her twisted childish game. Oh my gosh. Bummer. Was hoping to do some nasty stuff. Still can't believe Brian had to take her away like that. See, we were reading about this. Who is on this phone right now? Well, it's like Sam need to make people feel sorry. She didn't mention something about dad in her diary. Dad. Wasn't it B or Brian that said their dad passed away? This game is messed up. Sounds fun. But how? Leave it to me. Just keep reading her diary once in a while. See, I knew it. I knew that the person reading this diary is not the same person that wrote it. What happened though? I hear my cat meowing. Okay. Stacy, no. Now, okay, now it sounds like we are, now it sounds like that breathing sounded like a guy's breathing. The diary had no special meaning to me. Not until I read about how Brian took that on a town of the town.
Ah! My gosh! My brain is like, stop it! CPU overload! I haven't had to think this much in a long time!
He had no interest in girls whatsoever, and suddenly he's hanging out with an outsider. That moment I got tired of doing nothing. I knew I had to do something, so I gave Stacy an idea. It was...
Who wrote this journal is the same person who's texting.
It was gonna be easy. Spike her drink, get her wasted, and humiliate her. Out of the city girl in front of everyone. Only then would she know her place. It could have been so simple. Only if B didn't get in the way. What the heck, man? Don't even know how to describe what happened this morning. My hands are shaking again. It started when I opened my locker and something poured out. Well, for a few seconds, my brain was cut off from whatever was happening. When I finally looked down, dozens of pictures scattered on the wall. All pictures were pictures of Brian with gibberish written on them. The whole school was at the hall. They looked at pictures, then at me, and then at pictures. Brian was there too. The face he gave me, the face of disgust. He turned away and left. He didn't even say anything. I tried to chase him, say something, anything to him. But the floor started spinning and people started whispering like they knew what was going on. The air began to choke my throat. I swept what was under the floor, what was on the floor, and ran off to class. Of course, Stacy must have something to do with this. I looked for her, but she was nowhere to be found. The rest of the day was about nothing but about avoiding contact. Can't sleep. Brian's not in any of my texts.
Okay, I think we're almost done.
B kept saying nothing was going on between them. Lies. Everything. But I wasn't about to believe everything that was just rainbows. How could you lies? Wow. In my eyes, Sam was using Brian to fill her sad, empty life. I couldn't let that happen.
So, Sam and Brian are different people than who wrote this journal in B. Or is Brian the same Brian, but...
This person who wrote this journal calls him B. She wanted drama she didn't deserve. She doesn't deserve crap. She doesn't just get to barge in and start stealing the life I've only dreamed of. Stacy kept doing what she does best, digging in other secrets. She sent pictures of the little crap's diary pages to me. That's how I found out about her little trip to Colton Hill. It was our hideout since the year, and her presence turned into nothing. How could B do this to us?
Okay, so B is Brian. But the person reading this diary calls them B, or that wrote this diary calls them B, versus Sam just referred to him as Brian. So it's like this girl and then Sam and Brian, where this person's calls Brian B, I think.
Okay, editing Aaron here. I think I figured it out. I think we were playing as Brian and the diary is Kyle's, and the pieces of paper tacked up on the wall are pages from Sam's diary. The only way to speak to them apart was to show Brian what a creep she was. I kept reading the disgusting words she wrote on her diary. At the same time, I felt something. I reminded of how I felt when I felt B, how it felt so right and terribly wrong. Screening my pillow never helped with making the feelings go away. Find the diary yet? Yes, I assume so. I think you're taking it. Babe. As far as the phone goes, I'm pretty sure this is Kyle's phone, so we're seeing his conversation with Stacy, trying to get Stacy to steal Sam's diary so he can frame her and break Sam and Brian up.
I don't think she knows. I'm sleeping in her room. I can't find anybody better than you. Don't you think you're too obsessed to break them up? You're giving up now? Forget it. Please, babe. Maybe Brian doesn't even like the girl.
Not gonna lie, my back is sore.
Usually I don't sit and record for like 7 hours at once. This is the last one. It has to be. November 7th. The school counselor called me today. Mr. Ferns or Femmes asked me if the rumors were true. Rumors that I've been leaving hard drawings all over at school. Rumors that I've been stalking Brian. At this point, the whole school must be out of its mind. I don't even know the letters. I didn't even know when the letters in the hearts spell S and B. And what? Just because the initials are S and B, suddenly every name with them starts with either Sam or Brian. And guess what? It's even crazier. Sam Holt, the daughter of a child molester, craves forbidden love. What? Wow. Okay. Curveball. How on earth does Stacy find out about Dad? Why would she do so much to F up my life? Where the F is she? Is she? You know what? I'm tired. I'm tired of waiting for Brian to listen to me. I'm tired of looking for words to subscribe. Brian, please say something. Oh my gosh. Or don't. Then I remembered she wrote something about her dad. Must have been to do with an existence in my life. I started digging it, and it wasn't even a challenge. Keith Holt, arrested for sexually assault and teenager. It was beautiful. I found the perfect ending. All I had to do was next was fill in the rest of the story. How could Sam not... If my dad went on the news for touching teenage girls, that's bye-bye. Why? Come. Guys, this game is twisted. Calls Brian from the payphone in the middle of the night and silently listened to his voice. Mike. Man, still can't believe I go to school with a celebrity. That Sam girl's got some balls showing up to a class when everybody's talking about her pervy dad. Respect. Respect. Takes Brian's pictures and keeps them hidden in her locker. Gina, you know, you've seen everything when your classmate's dad touched you. How did she even get married? How did he even get married? Maybe Sam's mom is that creep's victim. Sam Holt draws hearts all over the school and lets other know Brian is hers. A needy city girl, she was a disaster waiting to happen. No one, even Brian, would think otherwise. I made all the preparations while Stacy spread the rumors I created. It was never easy. I once almost got caught taking a picture of Brian using the restroom. So everybody's picking on her, basically. But I kept going. Every picture I took was a love confession I could never make. Every heart. I think this person framed Stacy or Sam or S. In the end, I got what I wanted. When enough suspicion piled on Sam, I stuffed all the pictures in her locker. It was a happy coincidence that B was there to see the spectacle unfold. Spectacle. It was over. Things were about to turn back normal, and then Stacy's drama-filled head exploded.
Bro, what?
What did I do with these? Hide. Okay. I gotta say, this game is really, really good, but holy cow. Man, I haven't had to wrap my brain around this much information in a long time. Okay, so, I got what I was supposed to do now. Okay. Finally move on. Hello, JK, you're gonna die. I'm done watching you get away. You done to me. Did you really think I wouldn't find out? You've been using me to break Sam and Brian apart so you can have some fun with her. Well, I had my share of fun when I told Brian what you've been doing. You should have seen the face he made when I got to the part of you drawing those hearts all over the school. Hope you enjoyed your happy life now that there's no Brian to get in your way. By the way, I saw you staring at the college poster, but did you like the girl on the poster too? Is that why you tore her face off? You need help. Don't bother calling me Stacy. Okay. It keeps going. Oh my gosh. What the heck? Okay. No, maybe not. Okay. Please, man. Huh? Stacy got it all wrong.
And this is Brian finding out that Kyle's been framing everything, and this is their conversation, I assume.
It's just a misunderstanding. I was just trying to prevent Sam from getting into your head. Please, B, don't do this to me. Text me back. The day Stacy told Brian was the last day he talked to me, he was so angry at me he would never understand what I did for him. Typical, so typical. I was left alone to suffer. This time someone had to pay for it.
Okay. Hold up. Okay, wait. I can pick this up. I can pick that up. Okay, I see something down this way. I also see something down that way. Oh, it's that thing. Oh, okay. Don't get close to that thing. Ah! Oh, wait. What? What? Huh? Where am I? Am I at the bottom of a cliff? Oh no, I'm at the top. Okay, here's this again. Okay. Okay, who's this?
Okay, so I think I'm right in saying that this part is Kyle gave Sam a letter claiming that the letter was from Brian. So she thought she was coming here to meet Brian, but really Kyle was so jealous and came here, and I don't know if he meant to push her off, but she fell off. And it was all because of Kyle.
Kyle, what are you doing here? So Kyle pushed... Okay, so... Okay, so Kyle pushed her. But who's her? Sam? Ah, yes, the branch. Okay, wait. Kyle was what? Stacy's boyfriend, right? Burns it. Sam, meet me at... Yeah, he burns it. He tricks Sam to go meet him thinking it's, Brian. And he's... So Kyle was the one who did all this? Kyle stole her journal with Brian preparing for a rematch. So why did Kyle do this? Does Kyle like, Brian? I guess so. All right. I mean, that's the only explanation I can put together. Yeah, Kyle wanted to, yeah, because that would make sense. Like, Stacy's like, and then she said earlier, like, I never really saw, or, no, but she was talking about Brian didn't have any interests in girls, but then all of a sudden or something like that. Yeah, maybe Kyle and Brian were a thing before this then. Or that's what Kyle wanted. Or maybe Kyle's a friend that always hung around with Brian, but then Brian started to hang around with this girl, Sam or whatever, and then he didn't like it or something. I don't know. Kyle's crazy. I think that's what we can gather. I mean, there's needles all over the place. But whose needles are those though? That'd be hers, right? This is her room. Yeah. And the journals, diaries back. All right. Yep. Yeah. It was an accident. I meant to kill her. Maybe I did. Did I? But it doesn't matter now.
I left the team soon after what happened at Colton. Brian easily got accepted. He left town. The fact that he's a star. But I don't. Okay, now are we in his room then? So this must have been his room. And the diaries were two different diaries, maybe.
That is correct, Aaron. The diary that you're reading is Kyle's. And like I said earlier, the pieces of paper, the ripped out pages, were from Sam's.
He's been, maybe this is his. Why does Kyle, okay, whatever. He's been growing the idea since leaving him alone. Ash's dad didn't help much. He never got to talk about, Brian didn't really want to. Every time he hinted about leaving, I tried to start to ignore what it meant for me. Even those college posters laughing at me, they were making fun of me. They were all saying, hi, you see, you're going to die alone here. I knew that B took an interest in Sam. So now what? Is B just like his homie's name for like Brian? Hey, B. Because she was just a clueless new girl who was lonely enough to do anything for any guy who was nice to her, but jealousy start. I think this is Kyle's journal now. Jealousy, strong creature. I need someone to be mad at other than Brian, even after he left angry. And again, it's time to wake up. Wake up from what? To be greeted by the fact that I must start running around in circles again, that I must stick needles into my body so I can forget. Okay, so that explains that. It's like the story Miss Lace lastly told us about. Shortest horror story in the world. Trust me, they say the shortest horror story in the world. This is going on for like 7 hours. Last man on earth heard a knock on the door. I'm alone in my room and I'm alone in this world. There's someone knocking on the door. I don't know who it is, but I keep the door locked. No one comes in. Oh yeah, because didn't Sam say something like he never left? But that was Brian who never left. Okay, let's just wake up. Just open the door. I don't care who or what it is waiting for me. But what about my diary? The only one keep reminding myself how I'm the victim of everything that's happened. I don't know what I'd do without it. What will keep me from going insane? So here comes a big question. Should I keep it? No. No, it's time to admit. I've been keeping a memory of lies. No one to blame for this. I had to deal with it. It's about time I burned it. But after that? I could open the door here, facing whatever's waiting for me. Stay here in the fire and let go. Time to say goodbye. Oh, snap. Okay, here we go. What am I going to do? Because now I got to choose probably to run away or stay. And I don't know, man. My mind is not thinking straight. Who's that? Oh, I'm walking very slowly. Oh, I don't think it mattered. Don't throw some major twist. I thought this boy was in a dorm. Was he just gonna light the whole place on fire? I was finally awake. Do not tell me that this was just a dream. But I knew nothing was over. I needed to get what's coming to me. I told the police everything that happened 3 years ago. Won't fix what I've done, but at least I finally got the closure. I know it doesn't mean anything now, but goodbye, B. Signed. A game by Seiyun. Cho. Thanks to, I didn't even get to read that. Wow! This was, I think, hands down, probably the longest recording session. I've streamed for a long time, but like, this just didn't let up. My mind was constantly thinking. Okay, so now that this is over, let me just say the game, man, blew me away. Honestly, was really, really good. Let me know what you thought of it, actually. Let me know if you watched it all, because if you did, wow, kudos. Wow, that's insane. I still don't have all the questions answered. Normally, I'd talk more about the game in this outro, but I'm spent, you guys. It takes a lot of energy recording this video, despite it seeming... It seems easy, but it really does take energy out of you, talking constantly, trying to keep energy levels up. But anyway, if you like this, like and subscribe. I really appreciate the support. I do think that for the first part of the game, we were reading Sam's journal. Sam got pushed up with by Kyle. Kyle got jealous, and then it was like switching between Kyle's journal and hers, I think, and then the needles or whatever. So I think I pretty much pieced most of it together. Let me know what you think, though, if you have any other theories. Anyway, hope you have a great day. Wow, and I will see you in the next one. Oh, also, peep this new outro. Bye.